Oh my goodness, what it is upon the biz, everybody. It's the GRROVE, the Groove Master, coming at you. And I am welcoming you into another Groovy Good installment of Grappling with the Groove Master. I'm so glad to have y'all back again. Thank you so much for tuning on in into Grappling with the Groove Master. Oh my goodness. Ooh, lordy. So much has happened within WWE, especially over it with WrestleMania being gone and past. So let me just get right into a little bit of Raw. Kofi Kingston challenged Seth Rollins to a winner-takes-all match. Basically, Seth Rollins came in, you know, talked to the folks of Brooklyn, New York, say, we deserve this, it's our champion, which is the Universal Champion. Then Kofi Kingston and the New Day comes out with Kofi Kingston wearing the WWE Championship, and they get into some words to a point where it became Kofi Kingston challenging Seth Rollins on winner take all for both the WWE Championship and the Universal Championship. So Seth Rollins accept, and we got ourselves a match later on tonight. Alright. Up next we got Zack Ryder and Curt Hawkins, the new tag team champions. And they're going to defend their tag team titles, their newly crowned tag team championship, against the team that, you know, they took it from, the Revival. And I wonder if they're going to keep their streak. Well, tell you what, comes to find out that they did. They still won. And, you know, there's no looking back at that moment. There we got a Kurt Angle farewell speech, give a farewell to the fans, and then Baron Corbin comes out, you know, and then Kurt Angle shakes Corbin's hand and says, you know, wish him good luck, but, you know, not that much. Then give him the angle, then Kurt Angle gave Corbin the ankle slam, put him in the ankle lock, and then all of a sudden, this new guy, Lars Sullivan, shows up and beats up Kurt Angle. But I will say this, though. About time Sullivan came out. Originally, he was supposed to come on out earlier than that to take on John Cena, but, you know, for whatever reason, some speculated that Lars Sullivan got cold feet or something and didn't show up. So apparently they might have held him back for that time being until after WrestleMania, which is past Monday. Anywho, Lars Sullivan debuted, destroyed Kurt Angle. Alright. Then we have ourselves a squash match between Bayley and Alexa Bliss. Alexa Bliss came back. Good for her. But her beating up Bayley like that in a squash match, I don't know what the purpose was of that. I'm not sure if Bayley was punished or what, but I wasn't aware of that. Don't know what that all about. Then Becky Lynch comes on out. She walks around with both SmackDown and Women's title. And I tell you, it was so great to see Becky Lynch won. But I'm not sure about the finish of WrestleMania, though. Felt like, you know, Ronda's shoulders was up. But, you know, I don't know. I just didn't feel like it was a true feel-good moment. But I felt like Ronda was robbed. But On the other hand, though, I'm just happy that Becky Lynch won. All right. But then, as Becky Lynch get ready to make her way on out, here comes Lacey Evans, who I thought she's going to do a little catwalking thing, go back and forth. But to my surprise, you know, gave the woman's right to Becky Lynch. Like, wow. Didn't see that coming. Oh, my goodness. I find that amazing that for once, you know, Lacey Evans put a punch. I get it that she competed at NXT Mae Young's Classic, and she did have one match with Natalya on main event, but some folks probably ain't going to count all that. But yeah, you know, about time Lacey Evans done something other than just doing the catwalk, you know, walking back and forth. Yep. I was kind of glad that, you know, she got through all that. All right. Next up, we have Bobby Roode and Chad Gable. And I tell you, they took on Aleister Black and Ricochet. And I tell you, oh, my, oh, my. I believe that they got a new streak going on. And I tell you, about time that Roode and Gable, you know, they started to gain this new streak, this new mean streak. I think they started to slowly turn heel a little bit, which is pretty good. You know, I really can't wait to see how Roode and Gable go heel, you know, at least full heel at the moment. Next up, we have Bobby Lashley in a match against Dean Ambrose. This is Dean Ambrose's final Raw appearance. You know, it's a shame that we'll have to see Dean Ambrose go. Unfortunately, I personally would wish Dean Ambrose nothing but the best. It is, well, I don't want to sound like no job or anything, but but you know the whole saying goes, futures endeavors. But look here, I really am going to miss Dean Ambrose though. And dang, what a way to get cheap heat, Lashley, talking about Renee. Ooh, Lordy. All right. Anywho, Dean Ambrose got laid out on the table. Got Renee checking on Dean and all that. And that's pretty much where it ends from there. Now, for those who are in attendance in Brooklyn, y'all got a bonus that Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins, and Roman Reigns as the Shield. They unite one more time to say their final goodbyes for Dean Ambrose. All right. Then we got Sami Zayn making his return to the WWE. He took on the newly Intercontinental Champion Finn Balor. And pretty good match, although Sami Zayn didn't get the belt though, unfortunately. But he took a bit of a turn and was like, did y'all really miss me? I'm pretty sure you would, but guess what? I don't miss any of it at all from you. I was like, dang, he done gone Alexa Bliss on all of us. And then after all that speech he done did, he ended with, see you in hell. I was like, damn. Ooh, lordy. And then we have Elias getting ready to play his guitar. You know how it is upon the biz with Elias. Try to get his song out. but try not to get interrupted. And then all of a sudden, he talk about, mark my words, that the next man comes out as a dead man. What is that supposed to mean? And then all of a sudden, dong, the Undertaker. Oh my gosh. I would not expect the Undertaker to come on out. What surprises me is that he didn't show up at WrestleMania, which is like, okay, all right. And it's kind of a long, long time since Taker missed out on WrestleMania. I will say that. But wow. Anywho, just as Elias is getting ready to walk on out, he went back in, got the boot from Taker. Then all of a sudden, Tombstone. And that's all she wrote from there. And then there's a tag team. There is a main event, the winner-take-alls match between Kofi Kingston, the WWE champion, and Universal Champion Seth Rollins. It was all going well until the Bar shows up and ruined that. Now, my first thought was, oh, thank goodness they are keeping the title reign longer on Kofi Kingston for that matter. But, oh, my goodness, the folks of Brooklyn, New York was not happy with it. They were not happy with that. And then all of a sudden, here comes the tag team match between Kofi and Seth versus the Bar. I tell you, they weren't happy with that match. Nor the fact that they done kill a good match, for that matter. But anywho, Kofi Kingston and Seth Rollins won that match. And they stood tall with both of their respective belts. You know, Seth with the Universal title, Kofi Kingston with the WWE title. And that's all she wrote from there, from Raw. Oh yeah. It was a pretty alright show. Alright. It was all grooving good up in this neighborhood with that. And then going into SmackDown, New Day was celebrating with all the balloons and, you know, pancakes on corners. I tell you, it was all pretty good. The celebration was going well until the Bar shows up again, try to play spoilers again. But this time, the Bar brought in some extra company. Basically, what that is upon the biz is Drew McIntyre shows up. I'm like, wow, Drew McIntyre? Yeah, I understand that, you know, few days from now, they're going to have a superstar shakeup coming up. So they're trying to trade places with each brand and whatnot. So Drew McIntyre on SmackDown, and they're going to team up with the Bar, and they're going to go against the New Day, and which include Kofi Kingston being the WWE champion. Yep. So that was it. That was it from there. All right. Now we have a six-man tag match with Ali, Ricochet, and Aleister Black going up against Andrade, Shinsuke Nakamura, and Rusev. And I tell you, the best part of the match, all three of Ali, Ricochet, and Aleister sitting across each other Indian style. I was like, dang. That was cute. But anywho, they are far from cute like that, you know. Shoot. But anywho, after their match, Ali, Ricochet, and Aleister Black won. They defeated the other side of Rusev, Shinsuke Nakamura, and Andrade. Then, all of a sudden, Randy Orton, out of nowhere, does the RKO on Ali. Alright. And then just as Rusev, you know, tried to confront some of the folks out there, in comes Kevin Owens giving Rusev the stunner. Oh my. And that was just like, wow, where did that come from? First RKO out of nowhere, that's Randy Orton for you. And then Kevin Owens with a stunner. Gee, that's it's unbelievable. Unbelievable. All right. There we have a bit of a scuffle between R-Truth and Samoa Joe. But before all that, R-Truth wanted to congratulate Carmella for winning the Women's Battle Royale at WrestleMania. They were about to do the dance break. Then all of a sudden, Samoa Joe comes out, beats up R-Truth, and then makes a proclamation that anybody wants to step up to Joe, they can go ahead and have at it. And then out comes Braun Strowman. Like, uh-oh, this is going to be good. This is going to be good. You know, Strowman comes in, you know, get ready to beat up on Joe, does a couple of ring post splash, and then Samoa Joe tries to choke out Strowman, got him down to one knee, and then Strowman powers up, and just when, you know, Strowman goes for the power slam, try to go for it, but Joe, you know, got lucky and move out of the way. And that's when Joe took the U.S. title and ran with it. Because, by the way, that match with Rey Mysterio at WrestleMania with Samoa Joe, that was just a quickie. I don't know. It shouldn't be needed on the card anyway. I already explained that, at that last video I post. But, it was just not needed. Anywho, the Iconics come on in. They get ready to defend their titles against the Brooklyn Bells. I don't know who they are. All right. But I'm pretty sure they'd already made short work of them. But I will say that's a nice double team move by the Iconics. Looked like a wheelbarrow. And then Billy Kay puts the knee on one of the Brooklyn Bell's face. It was like, wow, that's deadly right there. That's a deadly move right there. Wow. I will say that. And then afterwards, Paige was watching their match. And Paige was backstage watching the match. And she was talking to, I forgot who it was, Dasha, Kayla Braxton, one of the interviewers, all right? And Paige mentioned that she got a tag team of her own that she'll bring up to go against the Iconics. So I wonder who would that be? You have to wait and find out, see. Then all of a sudden, we got Shane McMahon coming on out, and poor Greg Hamilton, that ring announcer, poor Greg Hamilton, he must have had a sore throat or something, you know, or at least, you know, it seems like it, because for him to go out and yell, best in the world, oh my gosh, that ought to kill him right there. And Shane McMahon is like, where's the oomph? Where's that WrestleMania oomph on that? Like, come on, you got to do better than that. You need to do better than that. Grab him by the tie all the way down to the entrance ramp. I was like, dude. Dude was like so savage with Greg Hamilton. Shane McMahon, I'm telling you. And then finally, the one last gasp of air of saying the best in the world. Oh my goodness. I was like, okay. At least he let him be. Let him be, let him go. Oh my goodness. All right, and then we got a tag team match with the Hardy Boys against the Usos for the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. And I tell you, it was a good match between those two. And then Jeff Hardy with the Swanton Bomb on one of the Usos, and all of a sudden, 8-time tag team champion. 8-time tag team champion. Wow. I was not expecting the Hardys to win. Like, wow, that's amazing. Whew. And they're legendary, too. You know, no doubt about it. Mm-hmm. It was amazing that the Hardys won for the tag team championships of SmackDown. So I got to give some kudos to them, you know. Then we have Becky Lynch coming out again with the dual women's championship. And then Lacey Evans come back, does the woman's right on Becky Lynch. Only this time, Becky Lynch didn't fight back this time. You know? I was like, okay. And now, going to the main event, we have The New Day versus Drew McIntyre and The Bar. Now, it was pretty good, you know. Sami Zayn showed up just teasing us a little bit, like, nah, y'all don't deserve me. I was like, oh lordy. alrighty, what it is for the biz, y'all. yes indeed. What's good, everybody? It's the Groove Master coming at you. And we are live and living color like no other. Stephanie, how you doing? Good to see you. We got Miss Becca. How you doing? All right, I'm trying to see if I can get Kevin Phoenix to join on in. Yo, what's up, Kevin Phoenix? Yes, the OSCW heavyweight champion, Kevin Phoenix, is in the house. Yes, indeed. Mm-hmm. We are live and living color right now. With grappling with the Groove Master. Check this out, y'all. We got the champ in the house. And I tell you, he's going to be up on here. We'll talk about how he is the OSCW champion. And what's he going to do this Sunday at the Windjammer in Isle of Palms, South Carolina. All right. I appreciate you coming on in, Kevin. Thank you so much for being here. We got Roman in the house. What's going on? Hello, Romana. Anywho, check this out. We have, I'm trying to see if I can get Kevin Phoenix to join on in. And, what we're going to do is that we are going to have Kevin Phoenix join on in, and he's going to tell y'all
how he became champion. And I guarantee you that, you know, it's going to be one of the best shows coming up this Sunday at the Windjammer. And I know the END is going to be right by supporting Kevin Phoenix. I guarantee you, ladies and gentlemen. Mm-hmm. Plus, on top of that, I tell you, you know, I can tell you that we got a great show coming up. Make sure y'all be there on April 14. We got a rock band coming up by Spongeworthy going to be there. That's a good question. I'm trying to figure this out too. You know, I thought they would have had some kind of button within this to get somebody to join on in video chat wise. I thought they would have had a button over there, but unfortunately, though, they don't. You know, I tried to see if I can have a joint screen on it somewhere. So y'all try to forgive me on this, y'all. This is actually my first time doing Facebook Live, you know, through here. All right. But I did have an earlier segment finish describing about Kofi Kingston's victory over at WrestleMania. And, you know, I wanted Kevin to come on in and, you know, give his few words on what he thought about Kofi Kingston winning. You know, dang. I'm trying to see if I could get Kevin Phoenix to get into this. But you know what, though? I might have an idea, though. I might have an idea. You know, this is probably what I can do. Before Kofi Mania, this is Phoenix Mania. Or should I say the Phenom of Phoenix. That's right. That is true, because it was about a couple of years ago, Kevin, that you captured the OSCW championship by pinning Tracer X. Am I correct? Am I correct? I remember that night. Oh my goodness, it was just absolutely amazing. You know, not many people would realize that Kevin Phoenix would reach at the top of the pinnacle of being part of OSCW, let alone being an OSCW champion. And you know what? I tell you, I was absolutely ecstatic that when it comes down between you, Kevin Phoenix, and Tracer X, oh my goodness. It was just absolutely just amazing. You know, hi, Christy, how you doing? You know, I couldn't believe it that, you know, we have so many different other competitors at that match where it was determined for the OSCW championship. Hey, Dodd, how you doing? Good to see you. And I was looking forward for, you know, I was really, really proud of the outcome of that match over at OSCW. And right now, you know, going into this Sunday, and you know what? You are absolutely right, Kevin. I feel that as a champion, you should be advertised on poster, but unfortunately, though, for some circumstances of reasons unknown, they decided that, you know, if they want to make some money or stuff, they would rather have, you know, they for some reason or another, I don't know why, but they would rather have legends and more popular names to be featured on it just to grab people's eyes and say, hey, I like that person. I want to see this. I'm going there. And I feel that, you know, in my humble opinion, you know, I feel that you should be, you know, at least have some sort of marquee within you, bro. You know, that's my humble opinion. You know, you're absolutely right, Kevin. You know, and there's not too many people realize that they don't know how to, you know, make their voice heard. But I'm pretty sure that we do have a voice. You know, people do indeed have a choice. Hey, Candy, how you doing? Cousin Pam, how you doing? I'm all right. I tell you, you know, I really, really feel that they should do more featuring the OICW champion, in my humble opinion. But see, I know that you have a fatal four-way match, Kevin, coming up this Sunday against three competitors that competed in a qualifying match at the last show in Hanahan Rec Center. And I'm pretty sure the answer to this is that you will, in fact, still walk out as OICW champion, as you are coming on in as OICW champion. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. You wouldn't, Kevin. You wouldn't do that. Throw the title into the ocean. I mean, I heard of surfer turf, but wow. Are you telling me, Kevin, that you're going to put the OSCW under the sea and have them swim for it? Oh, my goodness. Wow, man. Now you got people, you know, trying to get the surfboard swim on it. Oh, no. Oh, my goodness. Wow. Oh, wow. I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, all I can say is that make sure you come on in this Sunday at the Windjammer in Isle of Palms, South Carolina for OSCW Old School Championship Wrestling, just to see if Kevin Phoenix will retain his OSCW Heavyweight Championship against three other competitors in a fatal four-way match between Tracer X, Brandon Paradise, and Francisco Chiasto. Plus, also on hand, we will have a rock and roll band of Spongeworthy being there as well.